We've always said that SpaceX had no real competition, and maybe never would. But it looks like that's about to change. Yes, none other than Rocket Lab is here to take the trophy. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. In the dynamic landscape of the commercial space industry, SpaceX has long been the pace setter. With its reusable Falcon 9 and ambitious Starship program, redefining what's possible in space exploration. Traditional competitors like Blue Origin and United Launch Alliance, ULA, have struggled to keep pace. But a new player has emerged, quietly carving out a formidable presence, Rocket Lab. This private company, founded in 2006 by Peter Beck, has rapidly evolved from a small satellite launch provider to a serious contender poised to challenge industry giants. With its innovative Electron rocket already a success and its upcoming medium-lift Neutron rocket nearing its debut, Rocket Lab is making waves, even embarrassing established players like Blue Origin. This article explores Rocket Lab's remarkable achievements, particularly the groundbreaking development of Neutron and how it positions the company as a potential miniature SpaceX in the fiercely competitive space race. At first glance, Blue Origin, backed by Amazon founder Jeff Bezos, might seem to have the upper hand over Rocket Lab. With vast financial resources and a high-profile founder, Blue Origin has been developing its New Glenn orbital rocket, which successfully reached space in early 2025. However, the road to this milestone was arduous, taking 13 years from initial announcement to first flight, well beyond the company's original 2021 target. Delays, technical challenges with its BE-4 engines, and a cautious approach have left Blue Origin lagging in the orbital launch market. Despite its successes in suborbital tourism with New Shepard. In stark contrast, Rocket Lab, operating on a lean budget without billionaire backing, has achieved remarkable feats in a fraction of the time. Since its first Electron launch in 2017, the company has conducted over 60 missions, delivering small satellites to orbit with impressive reliability. Electron, a lightweight rocket designed for small payloads, has become a workhorse for government and commercial clients, proving Rocket Lab's ability to execute rapidly and efficiently. While Blue Origin's New Glenn is a heavy lift vehicle aimed at large payloads, Rocket Lab's upcoming Neutron rocket targets the medium lift market, offering a nimble, cost-effective alternative. Neutron's development, which began in 2020, is on track for a debut launch by late 2025, a mere 5 years from concept to flight. This rapid timeline underscores Rocket Lab's agility and ambition, putting Blue Origin's protracted progress into sharp relief. A cornerstone of Rocket Lab's Neutron program is its innovative second stage, which recently completed rigorous qualification testing, marking a significant milestone toward its first flight. In a striking announcement on X, Rocket Lab shared visually captivating images of Neutron's second stage bathed in sunlight, accompanied by details of its testing achievements. The stage endured over 590 metric tons of force, including tensile loads, to demonstrate its structural resilience under extreme stress. It also underwent simulated flight operations in cryogenic conditions with integrated software, avionics, and guidance systems tested to replicate real mission scenarios. Pressurization and proof tests pushed the stage to 125% of its maximum operating pressure while under mechanical stress, confirming its readiness for the rigors of orbital flight. What sets Neutron's second stage apart is its unconventional design. Unlike traditional rockets, where the second stage sits atop the first and is supported from below, Neutron's second stage is suspended from the top, hanging inside the first stage's tank. This configuration leverages a lightweight carbon composite structure, reducing overall weight and enhancing efficiency. During flight, the first stage's cap opens in space, releasing the second stage, which then ignites its Archimedes engine to deliver the payload to orbit. This streamlined approach simplifies stage separation, minimizing the risk of failure. As Peter Beck might quip, it's a one-shot deal, like a cosmic getaway car. However, this design choice means Neutron's second stage is likely expendable, with only parts of the fairing potentially recoverable. While full reusability is a hallmark of SpaceX's Falcon 9, Rocket Lab's decision to use an expendable second stage avoids the complexities and costs of refurbishing upper stages. This pragmatic approach aligns with Rocket Lab's goal of balancing innovation with affordability, ensuring Neutron can compete in the medium lift market without the overhead of SpaceX's fully reusable systems. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content. Neutron's first stage is equally impressive, incorporating features that prioritize simplicity, reusability, and cost efficiency. One standout element is its static landing legs, a high-end engineering choice that eliminates the need for deployable or retractable gear. Static legs are simpler to design and build, reducing the risk of mechanical failure, a critical consideration for a rocket aiming to land vertically. If landing gear fails to extend or lock, the mission is doomed. By using static legs, Rocket Lab minimizes this risk and streamlines the refurbishment process. Static legs require minimal inspection between launches, saving vented by products and can be burnt off at the stake, saving time and money. The first stage also features an innovative Hungry Hippo fairing, a design that redefines payload protection and recovery. Unlike traditional fairings, which separate and fall into the ocean, Neutron's fairing remains attached to the first stage throughout the flight. The fairing opens to release the second stage and payload, then closes for the return to Earth, landing intact with the first stage. This approach eliminates the need for costly ocean recovery operations and allows the second stage to be lighter and more streamlined as it's fully enclosed within the first stage and fairing during launch. The Hungry Hippo design could accelerate launch cadence, enabling Rocket Lab to integrate a new second stage quickly for subsequent missions. Rocket Lab's ambition extends beyond Neutron's design to its recovery strategy. The company aims to achieve a vertical landing on Neutron's inaugural launch, a feat that underscores its confidence in its engineering capabilities. Drawing on experience from Electron recovery experiments, including mid-air helicopter captures and ocean splashdowns, Rocket Lab has honed precision recovery techniques. To support Neutron's landings, the company is repurposing an offshore barge into a state-of-the-art landing platform. This mobile, floating runway offers flexibility, enabling landings in optimal oceanic zones regardless of trajectory. Peter Beck has emphasized the transformative potential of this infrastructure. "Our innovative landing platform will dramatically expand access to space by unlocking a wider range of mission profiles that demand Neutron's full performance capabilities. By enabling rocket reusability, we're not just reducing costs, we're creating opportunities for more frequent and ambitious missions." The barge's mobility and tailored design position Rocket Lab to achieve rapid turnaround times, a critical factor in the competitive launch market. Rocket Lab's vision extends beyond launch services to the satellite market, where it recently introduced Flatellite, a groundbreaking satellite platform. Designed to meet the growing demand for affordable, scalable spacecraft, Flatellite features a flattened architecture that allows efficient stacking during launch. This maximizes payload capacity, reducing costs for customers building large constellations. Flatellite is our answer to an industry crying out for versatile, cost-effective satellites that can be produced at scale, Beck said. Its modular design supports customization for communications, Earth observation, or scientific research, while high-volume manufacturing ensures rapid delivery. Flatellite positions Rocket Lab to compete with industry leaders like SpaceX, OneWeb, and Amazon's Project Kuiper in the satellite constellation market. By integrating Flatellite with Neutron's launch system, Rocket Lab creates a seamless pipeline from satellite production to orbit, enhancing its end-to-end ecosystem. Beck described this as a bold strategic move to complete the final piece of our vision, signaling Rocket Lab's ambition to become a fully integrated space company. While Rocket Lab is not currently developing a crewed vehicle, Neutron's design incorporates considerations for human spaceflight. The company has hinted at a potential crewed variant or dedicated spacecraft in the future, reflecting its long-term vision. Neutron's lightweight construction, powerful Archimedes engines, and reusable first stage provide a strong foundation for such ambitions, positioning Rocket Lab to potentially follow in SpaceX's footsteps. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.